When it comes to jewelry making and repair, choosing the right solder type is the key to achieving a strong and seamless bond, guys. When soldering, I like to use a neutral flame, something like this. What you don't want is an oxidizing flame. It burns way too high. If your flame is not hot enough, it's gonna turn into a reducing flame, and you don't want that either. You want it right in the middle. You want a nice neutral flame. This'll get you what you want. When assembling our solitaire rings, we typically use 14 karat white easy solder, chipped or coupon, for both the shank and or the head. This allows us to get a clean and secure bond during assembly. We also use 14 karat white easy solder or coupon when attaching posts to earrings. For ring sizing, we switch to 14 karat white or yellow hard solder, dependent on the karat quality, to ensure a durable and long-lasting joint. In this example, I'll be soldering an earring post onto a square earring. I'm gonna mix it in my boric and alcohol mixture, heat it up, add a little bit of alcohol on my post, put a little drop of fire scoff on it, pick up a very small piece of 14 karat white easy solder, place it right in the center of the bar. I'm gonna go ahead and pick up my post now. Place my post where I think is the center. And there it is. Look to make sure it's straight. Place it in my pickle solution. Wait about 30 seconds. Usually the pickle will take off all of the boric and alcohol that's glazed on it. And then we'll just take it out, clean it up. And then we can check it for straightness. Is if you turn it and it doesn't wobble, it's straight. And that's how you do an earring with easy solder. In this example, I'm going to show you how to assemble a 6-prong head to a shank with solder. One of the things I like to do is to open up my shank. So what I do is I put it on a ring mandrel and I open it just a little bit because I don't want so much tension on the head and the shank that it might break. So I'm able to open it just a little bit. And then what I'm able to do at this point is fit the head into the shank easily. If you go a little too far, just close it up a little bit and then redo the head and it fits really nice. First, I'm gonna put it in my alcohol and boric solution, heat it up. What I also like to do is put a little fire scoff on it. Fire scoff is flux. I heat this up a little bit. Now I'm going to use my stainless or titanium pick, pick up a couple of pieces of solder. Then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna place it where I wanna flow it, right in the center of both of these. Pick up two more pieces, place it in the center of both of those. Flow it, equal heat everywhere, then use my copper tongs, put it in the pickle solution, wait about 15 seconds. What that'll do is it'll take off most of the boric and alcohol crystallization and also stop it from oxidizing. There it is. In this example, I'm gonna show you how to size up a 14 karat white gold ring using a preformed piece of stock. I'm gonna go ahead and boric and alcohol it. I've already put the preformed stock inside of it. Gonna heat it up. What I like to do is add a little bit of flux to it. In this case, I'm using fire scoff. There it is. Pick up my hard solder. I like to use a small amount. The less, the better. And you're gonna wanna have a really tight joint. Like to flow it a little bit. Pick up a couple more small pieces. Put it on the other side. Flow it completely through and through. There we go. Pick it up with my copper tongs, put it in my pickle solution, wait about 15 seconds, pull it out, clean it up, there it is. By selecting the right solder for the job, you can ensure a strong, clean, and professional finish in your jewelry work.